dog's mate. Who wins? You decide.
You're not even close. Think much
bigger. All right, can I have another go?
No. Do you know what? You're not having another go. I haven't got time for this because it's only Ultimate Finale Friday.
We're going to make this tonight. The first time ever we've been allowed in here whilst they're still in here, guys. Look at that.
Could easily arise.
Can't do that.
On the tree of temptation, I'll do what I like.
Now we've got a show.
No, no.
Can't turn the light off now. Oh, the shouting doesn't help. Shut up.
You think you're doing all this?
Don't tell me.
I am this close.
Whatever, man. Don't you kiss my. I'm not doing it. I'm telling you now. I'm not doing it.
We never got to our first wedding anniversary, and tomorrow would have been our fourth.
Oh, that's sad, Chantelle.
Yeah, I know. It's really sad. I still do love him. Like, do you know what? To be honest, I think I always will.
It was really lovely, man. There he was.
And it just really hit me today how hard it's been to be here with him. It's really been hard.
Are you all right? Can we get the Kleenex, please?
When I was talking to John, he sort of made me question who I am.
I have my dignity, and that's all. It might not be much.
They're celebrities. I'm not a celebrity. Just really upset. That's...
It's all bad enough.
I'm so sad that it's just all coming to an end.
Oh, no. She won't like that. That's not nice.
He's so good at this.
No!
Hello?
Oh, bloody country!
Oh, my God! Hi!
Where do you think we go from here?
Let's open one of these doors, bro, and then we are.
Chelsea's gone.
Thank you, Britain!
Nadia! Oh, Makosi! Michelle! Vanessa!
Seven of us in the final! Yeah!
Wow. Okay.
Really?
It's been so amazing!
Wasn't it?
Loved it?
Isn't it?
Loved it?
Was it? Oh, my good Lord! Look at it! It's only Zig and Zag! Some boys, are we call you eating breakfast? Hey?
Can I have a little bit?
We're just eating the leftovers.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now, boys, am I right in saying you've got some big guests on your show today?
Yes, we met them earlier. We met Davina, the queen of Big Brother.
No way.
Yes, yeah. And the boss, and we interviewed
Phil Edgar Jones, the boss of Big Brother.
Phil Edgar Jones.
Wow, Jones person,
yeah. Amazing.
All right, well, listen, boys, that lot through there might be able to see us in here, but earlier on we tried to pay an anonymous visit. It didn't go too well.
No.
We were rumbled immediately.
Yeah.
I was rumbled immediately. Anyway, take a look at this.
Have a look.
We've all been watching BBLBC.
Why, thank you.
Yeah.
I hope you enjoyed it.
Do
Do you think your presenting skills could be a success outside the house?
Not particularly. I think I operate very, very like close to the mark, and I say very inappropriate things that unprovoked, you know.
Preston?
Yes.
Brian?
Yeah?
Can you sit up?
Jesus, George. So demanding.
Sit on your knees, Brian.
Now, George.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Oh, how dare you! I find that offensive.
Now, boys, you've both been on guests on the show. What do you make of their style?
Overall presentation skills, I would say, I'd watch their show.
Preston?
I thought they were pretty good.
Do you think they could do George Lamb's job?
I'd like to see him give it a go.
One George Lamb, though.
We'll try.
They wouldn't be as sexy, obviously, George.
No.
Hey.
As it's all the girls together, Big Brother wants to know what you really think of the boys.
They stink.
Who's the most attractive?
Brian. Preston.
Predictable. Who has the worst habits and what are they?
Victor, because he belches in my face when I'm eating and I hate it.
Victor does stinky poos.
Who would be the best to bring home to Mum?
Preston.
Brian.
Preston. And Preston.
And Brian.
Who has the best body?
Preston.
Preston.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
The others compact. Have eaten too many cookies.
In particularly Brian.
Yeah.
Who's put on 20 inches since... Oh, around his waist.
I can't wait to see you tonight.
I can't wait to see you too. Bye, Emma.
Bye, Emma. Lovely eyes.
Bye, Emma.
They got you as well, then.
Yeah, but they knew it was you immediately.
Psst, oi, Badgerhead.
Yeah?
This is McFly. It's me, the tree.
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
Listen,
can I rob you?
I want you to do something for me. You know that Dave McCall?
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is the last ever Big Brother, and she's swanning around here without a care in the world.
I know.
Where's the emotion?
What a liberty.
I want to see her cry about the end of BB, and I want you two to be the ones to make it happen.
It's a bit mean.
I'll do it.
When you interview her later on, go in hard. Use every trick in the book and get her howling. I don't care how you do it, but I want to see tears.
Okay.
I want to see Big Brother's Big Mother turn into Big Brother.
What do we get if we do it, Tree?
You get nothing.
What? That's not fair.
You're giving me nothing, Tree.
Okay, listen, can we ask you a couple of questions?
But if you're quick.
What have you thought of your summer in here? Have you enjoyed it?
Oh, have I, heck. I don't know about you. It's been the worst 13 weeks of my entire life.
Really? I think it's been brilliant. You're so miserable.
What's next for you, Tree?
Well, I don't know. I haven't really thought about them past them not leaving tonight. Maybe I'll end up in some library if I'm lucky. Now, get lost anyway. Speaking to you two makes me feel like I'm watching some cheap show on BBC Three. And I'm better than that.
Can I touch you?
No.
Well, I am.
See you later, Tree.
See you later.
Now it's decision time, guys. One of that lot has to be crowned Ultimate Big Brother champ. Who wins?
You decide. And we'll see you after the break.
For Brian to win, call 090-11-323-021. For Chantelle to win, call 090-11-323-022. For Nick to win, call 090-11-323-027. For Nikki to win, call 090-11-323-028. For Preston to win, call 090-11-323-029. For Ulrika to win, call 090-11-323-030. For Victor to win, call 090-11-323-032. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline. Other networks may be higher and mobiles will cost considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in tonight's final.
Final ever edition of BBLB at 6:13, and it's Ultimate Finale Friday! In only a matter of hours, the winner of Ultimate Big Brother will be crowned.
But how have that lot been busying themselves in the lead up to the final? It's now time for a hijacked instalment of the news to find out.
What?
Yeah.
Hello, I'm David Schneider, and this is the news. At 2:38 yesterday, housemates were called into the diary room in order to offer up their thoughts and feelings on Big Brother. I'm warning you now, this could get emotional.
Big Brother's changed my life in the biggest way that anything could have.
I've realised I'm perfectly content to be defined by a TV show.
I'll be able to look back at this and sort of remember how to be ridiculous.
Big Brother from 2001 to now, in a sense, has more or less defined me as to who I am.
It's one of those experiences that's so unique, and I think it will stay with me for the rest of my life.
It's in my DNA now, it's in my blood.
It's changed my life for the better in so many ways.
Hello, I'm Andrew Stone, and this is the news. At 5:48 yesterday, housemates were gathered in the garden to mourn the passing of someone who was very close to our hearts.
As a child, it scandalised the nation when someone wrote some notes. As a young adult, he made headlines all around the world. And as a full-blown grown-up, well, he never became a full-grown up.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, the hour is nigh. And as you shut one enigmatic, unflinching eye, your ghost takes flight into the sky. An eye that witnessed escapades with wine bottles, jacuzzi nests, and other charades. We hope before the tears have dried, you'll be reincarnated on the other side.
Hello, I'm Dean Gaffney, and this is the news. After word spread of Big Brother's demise, housemates flocked forward to offer some kind words.
I didn't even get the chance to smooth him right over.
This was his personal favourite when he used to love that one. I used to get him every time. Oh.
And I remember the first time we met. Oh, he just blew me away completely.
Can't believe it. That man gave me all my dreams.
One thing that I'll say about Big Brother is that he always knew himself.
If you want to see the rest of that, then go to channel4.com/Big Brother. Also, pop back to the website later on tonight to see the lovely Emma talking to our ultimate winning housemate. I'm Dean Gaffney, and that was the news. Back to you guys.
Trevor McDonald, eat your heart out, but very well done, gentlemen. By a bunch of people who know exactly how our ultimate finalists will be feeling at this moment in time. It's Big Brother winners Craig Phillips, Anthony Hutton, Pete Bennett, and Josie Gibson. Yay! 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 I feel privileged to be in your company. How excited are you all for this evening?
I'm quite excited, yeah.
Not that. Teach it all back.
You're not that excited, Pete.
Nah, I'm not in there. I'd be excited if I wasn't in there going, yeah, I'll
get it. Are you all a bit sad about it ending?
Yeah, and I'm a little bit sad, yeah.
Yeah.
I've nearly shed a few tears myself, yeah.
Have you already?
Been emotional. Yeah, well, Davina got me going.
Okay, well, we'll shed a few more later.
All right.
Now, Craig, you've come face to face with your old nemesis, Nick, when you went into the house. Were you surprised that he didn't leave on Wednesday?
I was surprised, yeah. I thought he would have, but I think it's turning around for him now. I think he does good, and I want Nick to win.
Do you?
Yeah,
I was
going to
say,
how
do you think he will do this evening, though?
Sadly, I think Brian... Well, not sadly, because I love Brian a bit, but I think Brian will win, but I would love to see Nick win.
It's nice to see him there at the beginning and there at the end as
absolutely,
well.
Absolutely, yeah.
Now, Josie, you are the reigning champion.
Oh, no.
Does winning feel like a lifetime ago? Because it hasn't, you know, obviously been that long.
It feels
long,
like about a year and 3 months ago, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Part of you, last week.
Does part of you wish you were still in there for tonight? To be there
for tonight. But I had a little mini breakdown, so I knew it was time to go. But I do wish I was in there for tonight.
Do you think you'd have won it if you were still in there?
No, not with Brian.
Do you think she'd have won it? She'd still have been in there.
She'd have won.
Anthony, what's going to be going through their heads at this moment in time?
I reckon most of them are going to be thinking about winning at like. By that.
Never.
That's, what, would it be in the final or all that?
No, but I think they'd be nervous, excited.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously nervous, excited, but I mean, if it was me, I'd be wanting to win it.
Who's the most desperate to win, do you think?
I don't know about desperate, but I think because, okay, okay, because Brian, like, you know, Brian must have thought he's got a really good chance of being the favourite. I think he'll probably want to win the most, like.
Right. Pete, what do you think the mood's like in the house tonight? What was it like on your finale night?
My finale night was loads of fun, I think. It was lots of
you
fun.
You think?
Can't remember.
Long time ago.
It was good. It was nice. Yeah, we were a good laugh, I think.
And
so.
And what trappings can the winner expect when they come
out? Oh, they're going to get fed to the wolves when they come out, and they're not going to see any of their friends. They're going to be swept off, and then I hope not. That's what happened to me anyway. So, but okay, hopefully I have a better time.
And very quickly and finally, who each of you like to see win?
Nick Bateman, you've said. Yeah, definitely.
Brian or Eureka, I think.
Oh, picking two, because she's a bloody reigning champion.
Victor's class. Yeah. He's led, Ginny. Yeah.
Vote Nikki.
Thank you all so much. Enjoy the evening. And now it's over to Jordan.
Thank you, Emma. I'm now joined by three bitter, twisted, angry people, furious that they're not on the other side of those double doors to bask in the glory of being a finalist. It's evicted Ultimate Housemates, John McCosey and Michelle. Michelle, so close and yet so far. Do you wish you could run back through those doors, my love?
Well, I'm happy to be out. It was the right time for me to come out.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Did not see the smile on my face. I had my time. It was really, really great.
Were you watching last night?
Yes.
Did you see Nikki crying?
Yeah, I did.
Come on, crocodile tears.
I know. Was it real? Was it not? What do you think, George?
I'm not having it.
No.
What about you?
I don't think
we're not having it. And now, Chantelle does actually seem genuinely nervous about coming out. Do you think it's the prospect of not having Preston around anymore?
I think she's pretty hung up on Preston.
She is.
Yeah, totally. I've not seen that she's nervous to come out. She'll be fine.
Yeah?
Come on, yeah.
You'll be there, big smile for her, open
totally.
Arms. All right, Michelle, thank you very much. Right, McCosey, hello, my love. How are you? Easy. What's been your highlight of Ultimate Big Brother?
I think the green suit really worked for me because I'm kind of known as the style queen where I come from.
You can tell that from today's get-up. You know what I'm saying?
And for me to wear that green suit, I was like, okay, fabulous. I can actually look whack and still feel confident.
Still pull it off. Right, okay. Now, if you'd have made it through to the final, what do you think you'd be thinking about right now?
Oh, my God. The emotions are being shredded right now. They all hope to win, unfortunately. And it's amazing. They're very nervous. I don't want to be in there.
All right. John Boy, if you hadn't been so keen to leave, do you think you would have made it through to the final?
No. The only person to be voted unanimously out by the housemates. The public hate me. Absolutely fantastic to be out.
John, do you think there's anybody in there who doesn't deserve to be in there?
Well, I think you've got to look at Nasty Nick, because he is a nice chap and he's being a nice chap.
But do you think he doesn't deserve to be in there?
No, and Nikki as well. She thinks greyhound racing is cruel. What's wrong with a woman? But I'll tell you one thing, she didn't do any of her tantrums when I was there. I told her, none of your hissy fits, none of it.
One-word answer, who's going to win?
Well, I think, it's going to be Brian, obviously, but right. I've pulled.
Who's going to win, Michelle?
I've pulled, not you.
I'm hoping Nasty Nick, actually.
Nasty Nick, who's going to win, Michelle?
I like Nasty Nick, but it's definitely going to be Brian, let's face it.
We'll have to wait and see what happens. Big thank you all, John McCosey and Michelle. Now, earlier, Zig and Zag caught up with Big Brother's matriarch and patriarch. Were they on best behaviour? Let's hope so.
Yes, viewers, this is Davina. She is live on E4. Please do not swear.
Yay!
And alongside her. Alongside her is the big daddy of Big Brother Creative Director, Mr. Philip Edgar Jones!
Yeah,
thank
you. He's the daddy! Yeah. A legend.
So many questions, so little time. Okay. Yes. Davina, tonight will be your last time to utter the word. Big Brother House, this is Davina. Are you sad about it?
I am. I think once I'm actually doing it, it'll feel really, really strange. It's sort of become my catchphrase, and the idea that I'm never going to say it again is too weird. And I haven't even been able to say that in rehearsals. I said, I'm not going to say it out loud.
Right.
No, this is the last time you're going to say it. And I was going, I'm not going to say it out loud. I'm going to save it for tonight.
Now, look, we've all seen you in your bikini in Series 6, right?
They were.
Yeah. Will there be a nudie streak on tonight's final show?
Will there?
Yes!
Will there? What do you think, Philip? Yes.
I think it's a good idea.
Yeah, me too. We're all for it.
Yes! Well, can I just say something? Yeah. I have waxed, so...
No, let's not do it then.
I don't know what that means, but I'm sure it's naughty.
Yes. Phil, do you ever feel the need to creatively direct the show in your panties?
Well,
yes,
I do wear a tiny Speedos when I'm doing it, when I'm in the office. We all have to wear tiny trunks. That's the part of the
rules. Tricks of the trade.
We've been making props for you. You've been sending up our tiny trunks, haven't you?
We have been setting everything up here in the props room.
Yeah. Yes.
Now, Davina, 10 years ago when Big Brother started, you were a fresh-faced 45-year-old. Back then, what were your expectations for the show?
Very, very low.
Really?
Very low.
Really? Now, honestly?
But no, because when I did it, you don't know what it's going to be like. All I knew that I'd seen this programme from Holland.
Yeah. Oh!
I can't stop kissing you. I'm so sorry. But anyway, I'd seen this programme in Holland and I thought, this is amazing. But then they'd
What?
It was a bit ruder in Holland,
shall we
say.
It was really rude, the first series. And I thought, oh my gosh, this is either going to finish my career or it's going to do really well.
Yeah.
And thank God it did work really well.
It did indeed.
Really well.
No, it did very well.
We're not as rude in Britain,
Phil,
of course.
Phil,
we're
not. Listen up, Phil. Phil, you won't be in charge after tomorrow, so you might as well listen up. As the daddy of the show, are you pleased with the brood that you've spawned? You know, do you have a favourite?
Oh, from all the housemates?
Yeah, the housemates.
Oh, I couldn't... Do you know what? I do... One of my favourites would still have to be Jade.
Jade.
I was very good friends with afterwards.
Yeah.
Up to a certain point. Yeah. And, I've liked them all for various reasons. I admire people who come on this programme and allow us to do all our evil little tasks to them. But you, of course, invent in the props room.
We do indeed in the props room. Our response.
Now, at the beginning of the summer, right, Series 7 was voted probably the favourite series of all time.
It was voted, yeah.
Yes, it was. But are you going to stick by that, guys, or has 11 pipped to the post, do you think?
11 was pretty brilliant. Yeah. I think the tasks were amazing. I still loved 5 as
three,
well.
3, 5, 7, 11.
Those very good. Yeah. Very
the
good.
Numbers.
Nice numbers.
Mm.
Yes. Now, Phil, recent Big Brothers haven't been... Well, they've been kind of singing and dancing and romping and hot tubs and lady men and mole men. Yeah. Looking back on the early series, were you surprised at how little actually went on?
Yes,
you know,
weird,
it's funny because after the first series, everybody thought, you can never do that. It's just people sitting around in a house and you can't do this again.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we did Celebrity Big Brother.
Yeah.
And that was just celebrities being ordinary people. Yeah. And it was, you can't do that again. But you can do it again.
Of course you can.
You can do it again.
Different people, different things.
Yes. We should do it on your planet.
One day. Nice one.
I don't know if
maybe
you do
you
it.
Now, Davina, right, you've been pregnant for every single series of Big
Yes,
Brother,
it's
right?
true. No, that's
and of course,
11
we know
kids.
You name the baby after whoever wins, right?
That's
but
true.
Now
we
the
know
show
that.
Is over, do you think you'll take a break from firing out babies all the time?
I am going to take a break because, as you know, I was 45 when I started.
Yes.
So it makes me 55 now.
Yes.
And really, it's time to stop.
It is time.
It's time to stop. Let it go.
And look, do you think you'll still call your mum up in every ad break, you know, ask her about stuff to cover
yes,
up your grey hair?
Yes, the grey hair.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, she needs it. But,
It's looking good, looking good.
Thanks, darling. Thanks.
Lovely.
All right, Davina, now, who do you find more attractive, Davina?
Yes.
George Lamb, who's my dad, by the way.
Yes.
Or Dermot O'Leary?
Oh, they both. That's really hard.
No, it's a question.
Sophie's choice. That's really a very good
lucky
question.
Lucky I don't have to answer that question.
No, you're going to answer
they're
that
They're very, very, very different.
Yeah.
You know, George Lamb is an amazing clothes horse. He's very, very handsome and very tall and everything.
Yeah, get on with it. Who is it?
Because Dermot and I have worked together for so long.
Yeah, Dermot and George. George and Dermot. Come on.
Dermot.
Final word.
Dermot.
I think they're both equally attractive. But not as attractive as you guys.
Thanks, Phil.
Without a doubt.
Well, do you know what? I have to say thank you very much, Phil Anker Jones and Davina McGuinness.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Big Brother didn't have BBLB, then Big Brother would be lost. Because
if it hadn't a little brother, then the Big Brother would not be Big Brother because they wouldn't have another brother to be big against.
Yeah.
What? it's at times like this when you're losing something you love, it's important that you surround yourself with friends.
Yeah, you're right about
and
that.
And luckily for us here at BBLB, we are more popular than Sam Pepper's Twitter page.
Damn right we are.
We're now joined...
Ain't that the truth?
...by friends of the show, and Dean Gaffney.
Oh, hello, team. Hey.
David Schneider.
That's
my name. I think you have watched every single episode along with me.
I think I have. I don't know what I'm going to do as of tomorrow. I have to start having a life, but yeah.
What's been your favourite series?
Ooh, interesting.
I
think obviously series 5, the bed sit, the fight, that was good though. Don't fight at home. I liked series 9. I did like the last series. I liked the whole Noreen and the love affairs that kept on going on. Sri and Sea of Ash and Marcus.
He's genuinely going to be heartbroken when he finishes. He lives with Big Brother, seriously.
Yeah. Favourite housemate?
Favourite housemate ever?
Yeah.
Well, I think it's an obvious choice, but I think it's Nikki. I think it wasn't until Ultimate Big Brother where her story is just, you know, the phenomenal, that the stuff with Vanessa.
The struggle. Nikki's struggle.
It was there. There's, you know, All right, EastEnders struggle.
Who do you think is going to win, mate?
Who do I think is going to win? Well, I hope that it's an exact tie between Preston and Chantel. That's what I'm hoping for.
Okay.
Jemima, David Schneider, everybody. Thank you.
You have been predicting everything that's happened in Big Brother this year through asparagus,
yes.
And you've been doing it really well.
Yes.
So, for one final time, can you tell us through asparagus who is going to win tonight?
Ladies and gentlemen, please, silence on the floor. Silence on the floor. Silence. What's the asparagus
Brian.
Saying? Brian! It's almost like she threw it at Brian. That's incredible.
Thank you, Jemima.
It's got to be Brian.
Do you think Brian's going to win?
I think he's going to
win. He is now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lee, you're the master of the Geek Chic haircut. Yes. Has Preston's hairdo got anything to do with you?
It hasn't, but I think it's bang on, to be
would
fair.
Would you be proud of it?
I would
good,
be. It's got that 50s kind of grey twins vibe on the money.
Good vibe on the money.
Let's go
Lee.
See
Thank
John.
You.
John.
Thank you.
You're, of course, the animal man. Mm. And may I just say, what an incredible suit John's got on this evening.
Nice
to bring a bit of showbiz into our lives. You were speaking to the gorilla all week. What's he telling you?
Well, he's telling me, too, that Brian's well in favour here, but there's going to be two. The papers will herald two winners.
Really?
Oh, OK.
Who knows? Maybe it's a Chantel Preston thing. Who knows,
Maybe.
Guys? Right.
Thank you, John. Thank you. Andrew Stone.
Hello.
You went into the Big Brother 11 house.
I did.
But how do you think it would have gone if you'd have been in there with the Ultimate housemates? Would it have been better?
I don't think so. I'm a big fan of the BB 11 lot, and they couldn't have been better, really. So.
Oh, nice. Who's your ultimate winner?
Well, the asparagus is saying it all, isn't it, really? Brian.
Brian.
Yeah.
Brian. It looks like
you're going
Brian.
With that as well.
Who would Jesus want?
Well, he's in love
and
with Josie.
I'm not talking about our Lord. I'm talking about his bandmate.
Josie's like kind of in love with Josie, really. So okay. He's happy anyway. So Brian probably.
Dean, you've been watching it avidly, haven't you?
I have indeed.
Who would you like to see win?
I want to be a bit controversial. I want to see Victor win.
Yeah. Yeah.
Victor's a goodie.
Controversy. Right, OK, we've
You're
got
amazing.
One... Thanks, babe. We've got one more thing that we'd like you to do, everybody. It's our very own version of a Big Brother task. Emma,
yes.
Tell them what's up.
Right, to make things fair, we've put balls in here with all of your faces on into the Big Brother tombola, and we're going to select one randomly, and whoever it is will take part. Right?
Oh, my love, amazing. Let's spin the tombola. Come on, let's find a lucky winner, Carl.
Come on, Carl.
OK, I think we're kind of ready there.
Yeah?
OK. So, do you want to undo that, and then I'll do that, my love. I was going to do the whole thing for her, but I was going to let her do that bit. Right, now, because Pearl's got lovely little short, petite arms, I'll get this for her.
Legs.
I'm not looking. Just hold that up to that camera there, my love. Who is it? Tony D. Gaffney. Dean, can you come over here? The good news is there's no funny business. They've all got Dean's face on them, right?
In any way, shape, or form.
Over here.
Can you believe it?
Come on, Dean.
Oh, and let me tell you, it's smelling nice over here. In front of us sit four plates containing delicious morsels. All we need Dean to do is to gobble them like his life depended on it.
The smell
Victor managed it. Do you think you can do it, Dean? Do you think you...
The smell is...
Dean, do you think you can do it?
Are you going to take part?
Right, plate number one. Let's have plate number one. Let's get plate number one. Come on.
Right. This is okay.
Okay, this is fermented herring. Fermented it. Come on, get in on that. Come on, take a little bite. Quick as you can, Dean. Dean, quick as you can. Come on, Dean. Just try a little bit. Dean, try a little bit. Come on, Dean. Dean, come on. Dean, you've taken your money. Now eat the fish. Come on, Dean.
Come on, Dean. He's wasting time on the other
one. He's cheating. He's, don't pay him.
Can you
We're
do
not
it?
Paying him his fee for today. He is, Dean. Dean.
Did you put some in?
Dean, what's... OK, let's move on to the next one.
Should we try the second one?
Let's go on to the next one.
I can't tell you. You Which do not one? Want smell-o-vision.
Oh!
Chicken's feet.
Chicken's feet, Dean.
Are you going to...
I don't know.
Are you going to give it a go?
I'm so embarrassed, because I want to eat one, but
Dean, eat something. Come on, Dean. Right, OK, let's go to the next one.
Oh, he's going for a chicken foot.
Go on, Dean. Go on, Dean.
Go on, Dean. It's not a lie.
Right, there's a thousand-year-old egg.
Thousand-year-old egg.
Hey, you fancy
Do you
a bit of that
try
egg?
It?
Smell.
Oh, you know what, Dean? Oh! Didn't
Dean.
He do terribly, guys? Wasn't
Sorry.
It terrible?
Are you gonna
do it? Go on, Dean.
More than anything,
it's all over, Dean. Smell. Right, that's a foul. Dean needed, yeah, well done. He's drinking his milk. We'll be fine.
Never mind.
We'll let Dean recuperate whilst you watch this. It's been 9 years in the making with the baton passed from Dermot to me and now on to Emma and me. It's the original spin off show. We are BBLB.
And
this
we
is
are
our
the
best.
Best.
Hello there. Welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother, the show that tickles the soft underbelly, and it is very soft. Hi over there, that's my very own Cheers bar where everybody knows my name.
You are gorgeous.
You can't tell us day 46 and we're just getting bored at all, can you?
Yeah, it's fun.
And it gets a lot better than that.
For a bit of a cockfight, maybe, in there.
Apparently, they're not allowed to take their clothes off, so that remains unlikely.
Who do you think is going to go?
Who cares? We fancy the doors,
mate. That box around me. Oh, boy! Wait! Holding that the wrong way!
Stop flirting with me!
I can't help myself.
You're looking for some company, sir?
I'm looking... Yes, I am!
BBLB.
This is not for the faint-hearted.
Roll BT! No!
Zig and zag. Men can't do two things at once. No, stop messing with my hair, George.
I love you more than Kit, Gemma.
After the break,
you cheeky monkey.
Sorry. Do you mind?
You've got lovely to have.
Don't worry, I'll keep it clean.
My God, it's huge.
It's not going to hurt you.
That was huge, Joel. That was the size of an arm.
Sophie's puppies are
Sophie's puppies are
Hello.
How about now?
Enjoy the next few moments.
Pepper, is it on?
Drop down! Now, get down on your faces!
This is Big Brother. Can Corin come to the diary room?
Steve Truly, everybody. Wow. They made light work of that paper, didn't they?
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near?
Let me see your hands!
I think you look slamming.
Hey, those guys, they're bonkers,
those
aren't
guys.
They?
Only a tiny windy one. A tiny little one?
Yeah.
If you could say anything to George Lamb, what would you say?
You're a bit lush.
Who do you think you are?
Emma Willis.
Are these your friends?
Again, no surprise, I haven't tidied up.
Corin, get the camera straight, my love.
Ooh.
Anyway, no use crying over spilt milk. That was there, this is now. Still to come. No, genuinely,
so
I'm getting a little bit... I'm getting a bit upset. Still to come. We'll be chatting to Davina, but first, we need to focus on the job in hand, crowning your ultimate Big Brother housemate.
Who wins?
You decide!
See you in four.
For Brian to win, call 090-11-323-021. For Chantelle to win, call 090-11-323-022. For Nick to win, call 090-11-323-027. For Nikki to win, call 090-11-323-028. For Preston to win, call 090-11-323-029. For Ulrika to win, call 090-11-323-030. Victor to win, call 090-11-323-032. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline. Other networks may be higher and mobiles will cost considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in tonight's final.
Bye, Big Brother. I'm going to miss you loads. My summers might be the same without you. I can't believe the amazing people you've created and all the amazing fun things I've been able to watch over the years. Oh, it's emotional. See you later.
Hey guys.
Oh, but fear not. The evening is yet young, and we're now joined by the lady who will relish her role as tonight's mistress of ceremonies. Davina McCall!
How are you feeling, Davina? Are you managing to keep the emotions under wraps?
Yeah, no, I've only cried three times today. So
only
that's,
three times,
that's
okay.
Quite good.
If you feel like letting some more out, remember you're amongst friends, all right, my love?
No, no, I'm really. You've been trying to do this to me all day, George. Whenever I see you, you're trying to make me cry. Stop
it. Hey, come on.
Stop it.
Maybe I've got a pact. Maybe I've got a pact with a certain evil somebody.
Okay.
Who knows?
Okay.
It'd be nice to see him shed a tear, though.
Yes, exactly. Come on, George. Emotion.
Come on,
George. I nearly went on the best bits. Yeah, nearly went.
I was just holding on tight to him. What can we expect from tonight's show, Davina? Is it going to be a send-off?
It's going to be a huge celebration. It's definitely going to be a huge celebration. Of course, we've got ultimate. I keep forgetting that we've got the ultimate Big Brother winner.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I keep thinking this is the end and woo, but actually it's also
someone's actually going to win.
Yeah. Out of it, yeah.
And somebody's going to win. So we've got all of that happening in the first two shows.
Because there's 500 shows tonight, just so if anybody's not aware.
We've got four housemates coming out in the first show, and then the last three will come out in the second.
And in between,
we've got a show. You and me on Big Mouth.
And then there's another show.
And then Dermot. No, not
slight,
me. I'm not
slight bone to pick with you about the whole fancying Dermot thing more than me.
She's got a point, though.
Yeah, but Dermot and I were together longer.
She's given me all year.
You've got a new girlfriend.
Huh? Is that what this is all about?
I'm all right, I get it now.
I'm all right. But we can share the wealth.
What's going to happen? Easy, girls. What's going to happen when the credits roll tonight, then? How are you going to be feeling?
I'm going to really feel very mixed up, I would imagine. But my mum and dad are here, and Matthew's here, which is really exciting. And I think we're going to go to the bar, and I'm going to watch everybody get really horribly pissed. And it's really good drunk. I mean, I'm terribly sorry for that.
Right.
I shouldn't say that.
It's a very, very rude word. I'm so sorry.
But I would like to work after this show. So I am apologising.
Davina, what are you going to do with your summer next year? Is it going to be really weird for you?
I'm going to go on holiday. Brilliant.
For 3 months?
Yeah. Why not?
A 13-week holiday.
Sounds good to me.
What are you going to miss most about this place?
The crew.
Yeah?
The team. Seriously, honestly,
Describe to us.
I love these guys. I haven't worked with a more fun team ever. And we'll all watch each other's backs. We'll have a complete laugh. I've never run to work like I run to this. I've ran to this job for 10 years. I've never had a day where I've thought, oh, I don't want to go to work. I've loved it. And that's hugely been because of the people that I work with.
How are you
and
feeling now?
You know what I mean? This isn't like work. Yeah. I sit here and I look at you guys and I think, God, I'm having such a good time.
Is she going to cry? That's what we all want to know. Dorina McCall, you're a beautiful lady. We've had the loveliest time working with you. Give her a big round of applause.
Now, it's a more closely guarded secret than how long it takes George to do his hair before the show.
Not very long, some days.
What secret is that, I hear you asking?
Well, what secret is that?
It's the identity of the Big Brother puppeteer. The big man himself.
Yes,
the big cheese.
This is what happened when Emma and I went rather bravely in search of the man they call Big Brother, Davina. Watch closely. Come on then, we're going to play this. You got what?
Yeah, I want to hear what it says.
So here it is, the last Big Brother. Everybody's having fun. Look to the future now. It's only just begun.
I think we should find him, babe.
I've got a really bad feeling about it.
Just give me a name.
I can't tell you.
Give me a name.
I can't tell you.
Give me a name!
I can't tell you.
Give me a name!
You wouldn't believe me if I told you. The quiz overall, babe. You won the quiz. And we've made you this. This is all the art of all the housemates over the last 12 weeks. All right, my love?
Thank you.
There you go. So there you have it, the final BBB, done and dusted.
Good luck to all of the housemates that are left in there for tonight, and a huge thank you to the 255 housemates who've made the last 10 years so entertaining. Yes. I can't do it.
There's too many people to thank individually. Let's not forget all the members of the BBLB crew who've made this show so much fun. Thank you very much, guys. And to everybody at home, thank you for watching. We've had the best time. Lots of love. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.
sei lontana, sogno all'orizzonte, manca le parole. Time to say
over it. It's been rubbish for years.